Well, the talent and temperament. She was born with a thunderbolt on her right shoulder, and she just has a great temperament as a pitcher. But she's going to be tested today because this this Georgia ball club can hit the ball.
First pitch underway, strike one, fired in at Jaden Fields.
We're still very, very, very early into the season. I mean, both teams have played 10 games thus far. I've seen a lot of Clemson. This is the first time I've seen Georgia, but I've looked at their stats and read some stuff on them, and they swing the bat.
Throw over to first, and Fields is a race to begin the first.
Yep. Reedy Davenport, the third baseman, is a transfer in here from Florida Gulf Coast University. She's a graduate senior, and she's come in and kind of been a part of this reworked infield for the Tigers. She's come in and fit in very nicely at third base. She's a two-time All-Conference defender while at Florida Gulf Coast. They were able to slide Maddie Moore over to second base. She played third last year, and Logaleo came in and acquired work at shortstop, and then over at first base, of course, you've got Madison May, who's not in a batting order, but she is in there for defensive purposes.
This is Davis, bouncer over to May, who you just touched on, second out of the inning.
There's Tim Cassati down there on first base. Known him a long time. He's an excellent umpire.
Jim Cooper behind home plate. John Hish over at third. Well, you touched on Georgia and their offense. Georgia leads the SEC doubles, triples, and home runs through the first 10 games.
They swing it. I mean, the SEC is a loaded conference, and Georgia offensively is as good as anybody. Depth may be a question. There's some great teams in that SEC. But Georgia always puts together a ball club that's offensive.
Peel down to first, goes around for a strike. Count sits at 0-2 on Sarah Mosley. Another look.
Yeah. I guess early in the game, that's a swing.
Here's the 0-2. That's upstairs. Not later on in the game?
Yeah, no, it could, you know, if there were runners on base in a key spot, you may not want them to make that call.
Right. Mosley's a senior from Georgia, first team SEC last year, and a big swing and a miss. First strikeout of the game for Valerie Cagle. Quick work for the Tigers. In the top of the first, it's a 1-2-3, no score between Clemson and Georgia. A look at Clemson's lineup this afternoon. Mackenzie Clark will lead off, two-time ACC selection. The All-American Valerie Cagle is hitting third. This is a Clemson team that leads the ACC in doubles and home runs. Defensively for Georgia, the outfield, Goodwin, Kearney, Chamblee, the infield from third to first, Mosley, Armistead, Kuma, Fields, Miller behind the plate catching, and the starting pitcher for Georgia, it's Kylie Macy, a sophomore out of Grayson, Georgia, who delivers a first pitch that misses to Clark for ball one.
Mackenzie Clark is a dynamic 5-tool player. The junior center fielder is just one of the elite outfielders in the country.
And she turns on this one.
Yeah, Graham, I want you just to appreciate this. Coming into today, she's hitting 542. Okay, in 10 games. She has struck out twice while walking 10 times already and has collected 13 hits on the season.
That's upstairs, 2-1. Those 10 walks, by the way, that is the most for any player in the ACC.
And she also hits the ball with great power. She runs very well. And perhaps the best part of her game is she is an elite outfielder.
That one catches the corner, 2-2. Macy did not pitch against Clemson last year.
She put together a great year last year, but as you said, the Tigers didn't see her.
It's up and outside, full count.
Season's very much in its infancy. She's already worked 9.2 innings, got a 1-0 record, has picked up a save. And she's around the plate. She doesn't walk many.
Lifted in the air to left field. It's deep. This ball is way out of here. Mackenzie Clark goes deep in the bottom of the first, and Clemson leads Georgia 1-0 after the fifth home run this season for Clark.
This looks like a replay of what happened here the other day. You see that ball is just driven just way out of the ballpark. But Sunday against Ohio State, these Clemson Tigers were up 4-0 after four batters. Three balls left the ballpark, and it was a double in between. Clark led off the game with a home run, as she just did. And Maddie Moore came behind her with a double. And then they were off to the races.
First home run of the season that Macy has allowed. Response by throwing a strike to Maddie Moore.
You know, I was bragging about how well Clark runs. When you hit him that far, you don't have to run.
Right.
She hit that ball a very long way.
You can run at your own pace. That's up and outside. One ball, one strike. Moore's a sophomore at Loomis, California. She's off to a great start as well, hitting 357. There's a base hit up the middle. Maddie Moore with a single. So the first two have reached here for Clemson to begin the bottom of the first.
You see right here, she does a great job of staying balanced. Didn't try to do too much with it. Hit it where it was pitched and got a runner on base for the most dangerous batter in the park.
Which is Valerie Cagle, the junior out of Yorktown, Virginia. When you look at Clemson, their numbers really are eye-popping. Most hits in the ACC, most runs scored. As a team, Clemson hits 415.
They are just a tremendous balanced lineup. They just go, go, go. And this one right here, it goes as good as anybody around. Cagle is just a phenomenal hitter to go along with an elite pitcher.
Cagle herself leads the ACC in home runs, doubles, and hits.
Yep. Other than that, she's not doing much.
That's in the dirt. Skips away from Miller as Maddie Moore easily advances to second. So 2-1 count on Cagle.
Well, If you're Kylie Macy right now, you just got to settle down and control your emotions. I know that you feel like you've been just blindsided. Clark's ball was hit so sharply.
Yeah.
It went so quickly out of the ballpark, and now you follow that with a single, and you got the wild pitch, and now you got this right here to deal with, 3-1. This is a big pitch for this young woman.
Just misses outside. Her first walk that she's allowed, and the first three in reach for the Tigers.
And to be honest with you, with a base open, worst things could have happened. They still may, but they sure could. Now, this young woman right here, Caroline Jacobson, transfer in from Duke. And she's been asked to come in here to fill in the role of Marissa Gambarda, who hit in a four-hole the first couple of years that softball was at Clemson, and she protected Valerie Cagle all those years. And Jacobson is doing a good job of picking up where Marissa left off. She's hitting 467, and she's got pop in the bat.
So Clemson off to a good start today. Here's what they did a season ago, or not a season
no, that's
ago, but
last
a week,
week
ago.
Yeah, that
outscoring
was like a,
opponents.
That looks like a good month.
Right.
And that
Look
was
that,
a good
43
days.
To 5.
That was a good 3 days. 4 days, excuse me, 4 days. So they had a midweek game at Clemson. I mean, at Furman.
Won four games in the ACC Big Ten Challenge, taking on Northwestern and Ohio State. Ball one on Jacobson. So that was Chelsea Wilkinson that just came out for Georgia in the circle. Trying to calm down her sophomore, Kylie Macy. This is blasted to left field. Good one on the move. It's off the top of the wall. Moore scores. Cagle slams on the brakes at third. It's an RBI double for Jacobson, her second this season, and the Tigers lead it 2-0.
That ball was hit sharp. If it had a little bit more loft on it, it would have got out of here easily. That ball was hit very hard, and she cruised in with the double. Moore scores very easily. Cagle gets around to third base, and Jacobson sits out there at second base, and there are nobody out, and it looks like, I'm not sure, but it looks like we're going to have a pitching change already.
Clemson so far, two runs on three hits, still no outs this inning. Valerie Cagle's at third, Jacobson is on second. Pitching change early for Georgia. We'll step aside and show you the new pitcher for the Bulldogs when we come back. New pitcher in the circle for Georgia, Shelby Walters, grad transfer from Duke, 4 years pitching for the Blue Devils. No stranger to competing against Clemson.
No, she has faced the Tigers twice, and in two games she's only given up one earned run. She defeated Clemson 2-1 back in 2 years ago, and then last year the Tigers got the better of her, but she spent 4 years at Duke, including the COVID year. And she's come to play her graduate year down at Georgia. But the Clemson coaches and most of the team are very familiar with her.
First pitch is a strike to Logaleo. Junior out of Nashville, Tennessee, takes ball one. Well, the line for the moment for Kylie Macy did not record an out. Three hits, two runs, both earned, one walk. She is responsible for both runners on base.
This happens a lot. I mean, when Clemson scores, they score in bunches. I mean, they can just sit there and sit there and sit there, and you think everything's going pretty good if you're the opposition, and then the next thing you know, bang, 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 and you're in a mess. And that's what just happened here, and we've seen it happen a couple of times over the weekend.
Here's a bunt. It's a good one. Play at the plate. Not in time. It's a 3-0 lead for Clemson. Valerie Cagle was able to slide underneath the tag attempt. Runners at third and first for the Tigers.
Now, how often do you see that? The cleanup hitter with the squeeze play. You look right here. Executed perfectly. Cagle goes in sliding. And Aaliyah beats it out. That should go as a fielder's choice with an RBI. But we'll see how it...
That's right. That is how it scored.
How it scored. There's John Rittman flashing signals, spotting that orange hat and pullover today.
You talk about Clemson and just how many runs and hits they can score in bunches. How much pressure does that put on an opposing team?
Well, eventually it takes all the pressure off because you know you beat. But it puts a lot of pressure on a ball club, because now she knows she's just trying to keep the ball game in hand right now. I mean, they're trying to keep right now. Their ultimate goal right now is to get an out, you know.
This is the sophomore, Abby Vieira.
Holds the bat very still and almost completely vertical as she begins her pre-pitch routine. She is a very good hitter and often overlooked, as a lot of people are in this Clemson lineup. I mean, my goodness, it's just so hard to not separate it. But, I mean, she's hitting 409. And she can drive the ball out of the ballpark.
Swats this foul for strike two. What does that do with a stance like that, just holding the bat so straight?
Nothing. I've talked about this before in the air. You know, you see all sorts of stances and starts, but the one common thread, if you look at all really, really good hitters, take a look at their bat and the ball at contact. They all look the same, I mean, basically. I mean, it just looks the same.
Softly hit right side. This will be the first out of the inning. Jacobson does not score from third.
Nope, she was not breaking on that play. Now, she'll be breaking on this one if the ball's put in play on the infield, but not there. They were able to easily get Logaleo down to second base. An out was recorded, but there was a little bit of production in it now because the runners are at second and third as opposed to first and second. And JoJo Hyde, who has been extremely hot, steps into the box. Graham, at one point early in the weekend, just 4 days ago, she was hitting over 800. And she's cooled off now to a very minimal 571. I mean, she is really off to a super start. Big fan of JoJo Hyde. She did a lot of the catching here the first couple years for these Clemson Tigers. And with the emergence of Fiera, she has shifted into the DH role very well. She also caught a game over the weekend. So she still gets her reps in behind the plate. But she really, I mean, when these pitchers were young and they were just getting started, I'm talking about Cagle, I'm talking about Thompson, I'm talking about Spencer. It was JoJo back there that was doing the work.
Part of this Clemson softball program from day one.
Yes. She's from Buford, Georgia, just down the road, just down 85, maybe about an hour away. Got a lot of Georgia kids in the lineup.
Check swing, it's close, misses inside, 2-2.
Even though Walters has played at Duke, she's a native of Cahutta, Georgia, which is up in the kind of up in the northeast Georgia mountains. Kind of, sort of.
Here's the 2-2. What an inning so far for the Tigers. Three runs on three hits. Starting with a bang, Mackenzie Clark, her fifth home run this season.
It was a big bang. That ball was gone off the bat.
Two, two. Full count.
This is at least the third time in this early part of the season that Clemson's been squaring off against a nationally ranked program. They had two games in here with Northwestern over the weekend, and now they got the number 17 Georgia Bulldogs here. Clemson opened up the season, depending on who you looked at the bottom of the top 10 or just out of the top 10, but they've quickly rose over the first couple of weeks to they're now sitting there number 5 in the country.
Yeah, they were preseason second in the ACC, only behind Florida State.
Yeah. Now this coming weekend, they've got a road trip where they will get tested. I know they see Tennessee over the weekend and a couple other quality opponents.
The Tampa's this weekend, tournament hosted by South Florida.
Yep. Kenny Erickson, the head coach down in South Florida, who was part of the 2004-2008 Olympic staff as the pitching coach for Mike Candred. John Rittman was also an assistant coach on that staff. And then
base hit in the corner right field. Jacobson scores. Logaleo scores. Heading for third, and she's going to get there. Sliding in safely, JoJo Hyatt with a bases-clearing triple. It's her first this season and the third of her career. Clemson rolling here in the first.
That ball stayed just fair. It looks like that Tony Baldwin has come out and asked for a replay. He thinks the ball might have gotten foul, but the ball hit the ground and it appeared to be over the bag. Now, since the ball had already hit the ground, it does not have to land in the fair territory. It has to be over the bag when it goes by. So this is going to be a very interesting replay. I don't know what type of angles they have, but, I mean, we'll see basically what they can look at. But the ball was driven into the ground in front of first base. So when the ball goes over the bag, all it's got to do is be, you know, over the bag, and it can land anywhere it wants to. Let's see what we see right here. Yeah, that's a fair ball. That's a fair ball, even on the second bounce, if you look. I think it lands just inside that. Right. So that was foul, but then you need to go back and look at where the ball was as it went over the bag.
Yeah.
See, that's a fair ball.
Yeah, that's a great shot right there.
That right there is definitive, in my opinion. Of course, I'm usually wrong.
Well, Scott, if this stands, what a plate appearance by Hyatt. That was a nine pitch at
yes,
bat.
Yes, she fought it off, fought it off, fought it. That's what she's been doing this year. She's really upped her game offensively.
So for the moment, it's a bases clearing triple, and it's going to stand.
It was confirmed as a fair ball. I thought so.
So again, for Clemson this inning, the only out was a ground ball out to the second baseman, and that's been it.
Yeah, and they're not done. McLeish, the left fielder, steps in. She transferred in from University of Wisconsin.
And she drops a bunt, and this will be foul.
Luckily for the Tigers, it went foul because the bunt didn't go very far, and I think that the catcher would have been waiting to say hi to JoJo on that one.
Tigers had a squeeze earlier this half inning.
Yes, they did. Marissa Miller doing the catching for the Bulldogs.
No bunt attempt shown that time. It's 1-1. McLeish, 164 games at Wisconsin, second team Big 12 selection.
She can really run, and she uses her legs to her advantage. You see her slap one foul down there by Coach Rittman, and he was able to demonstrate to the crowd here at McCorder Stadium of his agility and reactions. He jumped about 3 minutes after the ball went by.
What was your philosophy when you were coaching third? Did you try to make a play? Did you try
no,
to go after it?
No.
Stay away?
Quickest way to embarrass yourself in the world. I was so proud of myself for like 23 years or 24 years. I've never hit with a foul ball.
Really?
And then in my 26th season, I got nailed down there by a line drive, and man, did it hurt. I mean, I was, you know, I retired a couple years after that, but if I'd have got hit early in my career, I'd have probably retired then.
Here's a little flare hit to the shortstop. Armistead brings it in. That's the second out.
That's going to bring up Reedy Davenport.
We kind of touched on it earlier, but just how good has Clemson been offensively this season?
Those are pretty gaudy numbers if you see them right there. I think 742 in slugging percentage says a lot. That leads all of Division I, plus doubles per game.
Ninth batter this half inning, Reedy Davenport takes ball one.
That's a great job by our production crew and stat folks to get us those numbers.
That floats in for a strike. Davenport out of St. John's, Florida, played at Bartram Trail High School, same high school that Clemson great Kyle Parker went to, former quarterback.
How about that?
Outfielder, first round draft pick in the major leagues. Bouncing ball, Kuma has it. Third and final out of the inning. Big inning for Clemson. Five runs on four hits, started with a solo blast by Mackenzie Clark, her fifth this season. It's a five-run lead for Clemson. Head coach for Georgia, Tony Baldwin, second season as the full-time head coach, 9 seasons as an assistant coach before being named the head coach. The Georgia Bulldogs last year took on Duke in the NCAA regionals.
He worked under the tutelage of Lou Harris, who was a legendary coach there at Georgia for many years. He has coached teams to the World Series. He's coached teams to multiple NCAA playoff appearances. He is an outstanding coach.
Jada Kearney leads off. Junior out of Columbus, New Jersey. First team SEC pick last year. Thought process here for Georgia after giving up 5 runs last
year. Oh, that's, you know, I mean, a team like Georgia just doesn't have that happen to them a lot. And so now they just got to kind of hit the reset button, attack this game almost as if it's 0-0. You hadn't got to get all 5 back here. You see a ball easily grounded out to second base. You don't have to get all 5 back right away, but you do need to chip away at it, have something positive to build off of.
Valerie Cagle doing Valerie Cagle things in the circle. She's retired every batter that she has faced so far.
You know, and it's very easy for me to sit up here and say what they should do, particularly when they're working against a pitcher like Cagle. She's not going to make it easy for them.
No, not at all.
And it's just a real interesting contrast.
Big swing and a miss from Sydney Kuma. Touchstone her up top, senior out of Fresno, California, second team SEC last year.
Yeah. I mean, Cagle had a great year last season, but something that a lot of folks wouldn't know is that she was nicked and banged up the entire season a year ago. Nothing big, just a lot of little minor stuff. She played through it and never complained. Over the summer, the fall, and early this year, she's gotten completely healthy. Her velocity is back. And talking to the coaches at Clemson, she's just still a little bit away from hitting her rhythm. And I've watched her pitch now. This is my 5th time getting to watch her throw. And if she hadn't hit her rhythm yet, she is going to be a handful when she does.
Yeah, that's bad news for everybody that Clemson plays. 3-ball, 2-strikes, the count to Sydney Kuma. Georgia looking for the first base runner.
She's also an elite defender. She plays her position very well.
So does Davenport.
Yeah. Davenport's going to go in there and tell Cagle, don't do not throw her that again. That ball got to me very, very quickly. And Cagle's going to tell her to be quiet and get over there. So what else you want me to do? I got her to pop up. Ball wasn't on the ground, you know. Just catch it.
Goes around for the strike. Oh. So Sydney Chambly, a junior out of Dallas, Georgia.
Yep, that's over in Paulding County. That's not too far from my stomping ground.
East Georgia, east of Atlanta.
Oh. No, it's a little bit west of Atlanta.
West of Atlanta.
Yep. Don't get into geography with me now about Georgia here, Graham. You're the king of Mississippi. All right, but Georgia, I got this one covered.
You got Georgia?
Yeah, Paulding County rubs right up against Cobb County, which, of course, that's where Kennesaw State is located. So, like I said, they were right there in my hip pocket. A lot of good teams in the metropolitan Atlanta area. Georgia become a destination for recruiting. Obviously, the University of Georgia has a lot of Georgia players. But you see them scattered out now from Georgia all the way to Arizona.
Called strike 3, second strike out of the game for Valerie Cagle. She has retired all 6 batters that she's faced. As we head to the bottom of the second, it's a 5-run lead for Clemson. Second strike out of the day for Valerie Cagle. John Rittman, 4th season as the head coach at Clemson. He was hired November 3rd, 2017, and what a job he's done building this program.
Johnny Ballgame, that's my guy down there. I noticed today that because it's cold all weekend, but today they're in short pants, and he has not got his tan on yet for this year. We're going to have a chat about that. But he has done a fabulous job of the upload of this Clemson program. It was a terrific hire. The administration, the community, and everybody should be congratulated.
Armstead long throw to first, and it's in time to retire Mackenzie Clark.
Clark hit it sharply, but the shortstop made a fine play. Got over, got under the ball, made a firm, crisp throw to get out a very quick runner. And that shows you the importance of out one. Remember, after the first at bat last inning, they were down 1-0. And it led on to a big, big inning for the Tigers. There they got the leadoff runner out. Same player, because the Tigers batted around. But a completely different defensive attitude out there right now. You know, there's one out instead of one run. Maddie Moore doubled her last time up. Hit the ball almost through the fence out in left center.
Later came around to score as well. So Walters did not start this game. She's pitching in relief, and she's retired 3 in a row.
Yeah. She's a quality pitcher. I mean, and she's done a vast majority of the tough work so far for the Georgia Bulldogs this season. She's got 28 and 2/3 innings. Today's starter, Kylie Macy, on the other hand, only had 9.2 innings. So this is the quote-unquote workhorse of the staff.
And familiar with Clemson, as you touched on, this is her third time to pitch against the
right.
Tigers.
That's exactly right. And she had great success against the Tigers in 21 and 22. But this is 23, and the situation is a little bit different. Those young hitters that she faced the last 2 years, they've kind of all grown up now. So it's a little bit different kind of challenge.
Outside ball four. First base runner Walters has allowed. Second walk in the game allowed by a Georgia pitcher.
Now, Graham, I work, you know, basically exclusively here at Clemson doing color broadcast of home games. You travel around the SEC and the ACC doing games. Have you seen a more untanned set of legs this fall? I mean, this spring than John Rittman has right now?
I was wondering where you were going with that.
Oh.
Runner on the move to second. Throw down by Miller, not in time. Maddie Moore with a stolen base. It's the 12th of her career.
She got a great jump. And she goes in at first. The throw was up a little bit, but I don't think it gets her anyway. Now with one out, there's a runner in scoring position out there for Kegel.
Well, the key and the good news is it's February the 21st.
Correct.
So we still got some time.
Yeah, but that's just a shame to see that out of the box. They were in Florida 2 weeks ago. There's no need to have that white set of legs. So, but we'll make a note of it and move on from it.
Valerie Kegel walked and scored a run last inning. Shoots this one foul.
Fought that off 0-2. Good hitters to do that. We saw JoJo Hyatt do that. Foul off some pitches as she got one she liked earlier in the game.
Cleared the bases. Walters 0-2. Swing and a miss. Got Kegel with a rice ball, second out of the inning.
Jacobson looks much more relaxed out there, doesn't she? You see this ball starts out and just keeps rising. And Kegel chases it and can't come up to it.
That is just the second time Valerie Kegel has struck out this season.
Yeah. Now that ball was out of the zone when she swung at it, but let me tell you something. When she started her swing, that ball looked like it was in the sweet spot. Off-speed pitch right there, taken just off the plate for ball one. You got to believe that a base hit will score a run for the Tigers. And so you got to know that the Bulldogs want to do everything they can to prevent that from happening.
after giving up five runs last inning. 2-0 the count on Jacobson. She had the RBI double. These two were teammates a season ago.
Yeah, how about that now? That's they probably faced each other in a few inter-squad situations. Jacobson, another hitter, is very still in the batter's box.
Check swing, a little inside.
Yeah. You do have a base open, so you don't have to give in to Jacobson here. Of course, Logaleo's on deck, and that's no walk through the park. But you don't have to throw something right down the middle.
Yeah, Walters wants to attack it. Ripped up the middle towards center field, but Kearney snags it for the third and final out. Clemson leads the runner stranded on second. After two, it's a five-run lead for the Tigers. Great crowd tonight to watch Clemson take on Georgia and a pair of ranked teams, meeting for just the third time in program history. The first meeting was in Clemson back in 2020 before the season got shut down, and then they played last year in Athens in a 3-2 victory for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, they're very, very, very competitive so far in the early histories of this rivalry.
First pitch up and outside.
People got to know these two programs are only about 80 miles apart.
Not that far.
It's an easy trip. Fans love it in all sports. Saw a great shot of the fans. I mean, this is a tough ticket to get. Believe it or not, all seats in the bowl of the stadium are sold. Now, there are some Dave walk-up tickets available because they've expanded the berms here in the outfield at McCourta Stadium. But that demand was put on them because everybody wants to come out and see them play.
Swing and a miss, 1-2. Well, Clemson has been winning at a high level. 42 wins a season ago, 44 back in 2021.
See, that right there is what you call your basic new berm. That's not the old berm now, that's the new berm. And got a bunch of folks sitting out there as we see a strikeout. A bunch of people sitting out there on that new berm under the flagpole. Down the left field line is the old berm. You're going to see Cagle right here just go right by her, and she swings right through it.
Three strikeouts for Cagle. Got a lot to smile about so far in this one. She's retired seven straight.
Yeah, she is having a good day so far.
This is Ellie Armistead, a junior out of Matthews, Virginia.
She took a little bit off that. Now, if somebody throwing as hard as Cagle starts showing a changeup, that's just not fair.
Because she can do things like that.
Yeah, because she can spot everything. She's got excellent control. That was an easy line out.
Davenport's made a couple plays over there at third today. Georgia will have a new batter in the batter's box here in the ninth spot. It's a senior, Allie Curlin out of Virginia.
Hitting 250 on the season. Plays pepper with Cagle, and just like that, the third is done. More of the same.
Nine up, nine down for Georgia. Clemson 5, Georgia 0. Bottom of the third, Clemson 5, Georgia 0. Clemson has just been on a mission as of late. Told you they outscored opponents 33-5 over the weekend in the ACC Big Ten Challenge, and that's been the story so far.
Oh, man, has it ever been the story so far. And Cagle dealing like she is. I think she's thrown only 30 pitches in the game, but like 23 or 24 of them have been strikes. That's just incredible.
Yeah, that really is remarkable. We got 30 pitches, 23 have been strikes.
In case you don't know, folks, that's good.
Logaleo leading off. She's been an all-conference selection twice in her career.
She's faced 9 batters, okay, and thrown 7 balls. Now think about that.
That one just off the mark. Logaleo had the reached on a fielder's choice. It was a sacrifice bunt. And she was able to reach base safely.
Logaleo's an unsung hero too, because throughout her career, she's played in the outfield, she's played third base. She has taken on every challenge that Coach Rittman and his staff have asked of her. She played through some injuries a couple of years ago, but now she is really kind of coming into her own out there at shortstop and in the batter's box. Out of Nashville, Tennessee.
That one gets over from Walters, 3-1.
You know, there are softball teams in the country right now that if you add up their actual total attendance for the whole season at home, they don't draw like these Clemson Tigers do for home games. It's unbelievable. And that's not a knock on anybody. That's a compliment strictly to this community.
Exactly,
and
yeah.
These fans.
Three-two, foul back. And you were touching on Georgia earlier, just how much softball talent comes out of that state in this part of the country.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
People just starving for softball.
It really took on. It took, softball got into town in the Southeast really when the ACC and the SEC made a big push. I mean, I was playing it before they were at Kennesaw. Yeah. But when the SEC, when the big girls decided to come into town, this sport took off. And around 1996, 97,
yeah.
You know, and it was just an explosion, and it just hadn't stopped. See, Logaleo, well, they do a good job of sliding. You see, that's what you're taught to do. You did a good job there. Shortstop Armstead wishes she didn't have to do that, but she did, and she did it correctly.
3-2 from Walters. Popped up right side. Kuma has it. Nice job by Walters. She was behind in that at-bat 3-0, and she battles back to record the out.
Well, we know Walters is a quality pitcher. That's not even debatable. But she has come in here and done a really good job of kind of stopping the bleed and putting the brakes on this fast break offense that the Tigers have.
This is Abby Vieira. Jumps on the first pitch, caught by Kuma. One pitch, one out.
And they're not hitting anything hard off of her right now. There was a ball sharply hit by Clark for an out in the center field an inning ago, but other than that, it's been very, very easily fielded balls or strikeout.
JoJo Hyatt steps in. Last time she was in the box, 9 pitch at bat, cleared the bases with a triple. Boy, Walters has really done a nice job to stop the bleeding. She's only allowed 1 base runner.
That's correct. Now, 1 run did get hung on to her, but she has just she's kind of stabilized the game for Georgia.
Caught it first. Fields drops it, picks it back up, but this will be foul.
Yep, ball was well foul. You know, in the sport of softball, like baseball, it's not where the fielder's at, it's where the ball is. And the ball was clearly in foul territory, and she dropped it anyway, so it was a foul ball.
Oh, Walters has options on the 0-2 count. Goes inside and picks up her second strikeout.
That's
Clemson
the best
goes
option.
Down in order. 1-2-3.
That is the best option, my friend.
After three, Tigers up 5-0. The circle today, Valerie Cagle has been on cruise control for the Tigers.
She's just attacked the zone all day. I think we talked about it. Only 30 pitches, 23 of them strikes. And you see right there, she even feels her position. And you see that smile. That is what you call an emotional display by Valerie Cagle. That's about as much as you get right there. Very, very even killed, at least outwardly.
Three strikeouts for Cagle. Top of the order. There's Jaden Fields. Fouls the first pitch away. Did you have a preference for a pitcher? Do you want to see emotion or just stoic?
I would rather them be poker faced out there. I don't want anybody to know what they're thinking. Now, but if somebody's an emotional person, you're not going to try to change that.
All right.
You got to work with who they are. You can't change a personality.
Fields, senior out of Kennesaw, Georgia, hit a home run last year against Clemson.
Very good player.
Shoots this one, curling foul and out of play. Fields went to Harrison High School, won a 6A state championship. It's a sister and her brother. Brother is Justin Fields.
Yeah, I was about to say, I was going to mention that because they're from my area. Her brother's got a little talent.
Four strikeouts now for Valerie Cagle.
People may not remember, but Justin Fields, who now is with the Chicago Bears through Ohio State, actually began his career as a Georgia Bulldog before transferring up to Columbus. And his sister followed suit, coming down to play for the Dogs.
Cagle scoops it over to first. Already two outs for Georgia in the fourth.
Making it look very simple right now. It can change in an instant. But she's retired the first 12. Excuse me, first 11.
Mosley steps in, trying to reach for the first time for a Georgia player today. Mosley, a Georgian native, first team SEC pick last year. Went 0-for-3, did score a run against Clemson a season ago.
We were talking about it pregame, Graham, about how the Georgia uniform has got the logo right there front and center. That's the brand. You don't see that very often, maybe in bat and ball sports, that big and that prominent. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. It's just rare.
You know who it is when you see the logo.
Yeah.
Cagle blows that one by Mosley. 2-2 the count.
Now watch this, Buzz, a heavy drop ball. It just keeps going down.
This will be pitch number 10 this inning for Cagle, and it's fouled away. Where do you think Cagle has developed the most from day one to where she is today?
I just think it's been an organic maturation. I mean, she had all the tools when she got here, but the combination of her pitching coach Kyle Jamerson and, of course, head coach John Rittman and everybody here at Clemson has, as you see right here, she holds up on the I think that's the right call. But just an organic maturation. She's just getting better. There's not any one thing that she's done like head and shoulders. I think mental toughness is something she's gotten very good at because she managed her little nicks and injuries all year last year. And it's not fun to play this game when you got nagging injuries.
Right. Three and two the count. Georgia looking for their first base runner. Three, two from Cagle. Popped up on the infield. This will be 12 in a row, retired by Valerie Cagle. Clemson 5, Georgia 0. What a start for Cagle. Well, so far the difference in this game, it's been the first inning. All runs, all hits for Clemson, the first inning, and it started with a blast by Mackenzie Clark, her fifth home run of the season.
And what you don't see very often in a ball game, in the first inning, the Clemson batters hit for the cycle. We had a home run, a triple, a double, and a single in that inning. And circle in a fielder's choice in amongst it, and that's how you score five runs.
Kylie Macy started in the circle for Georgia. Since then, it's been Walters. Walters, three innings, one hit, one run, two strikeouts.
And, you know, she had to wiggle a little bit to get out of the situation in the first inning, but since then, she has been lights out. She's matched Cagle pitch for pitch.
Bunch shown, goes around for strike two.
Like it is very, very common to see Eklish try to put the bunt down.
That's outside, one and two. So this is the first true road game this season for Georgia. They started the season in a tournament and all home games since then.
Yeah.
That's in the dirt, 2-2. And as you touched on, this can be a very tough environment, tough place to play.
Yes, it is. And that's like I said, that starts in the athletic director's office. That goes all the way through the fans, the community, the area, and they have done a wonderful job. The marketing, the ticket people have just done a wonderful job of the upload of this program here.
That was close. Misses, 3-2. Georgia coming into this year, they were picked preseason 6 in the SEC by the coaches.
That's not bad in the SEC, though.
Yeah.
You look at those teams.
3-2, this will be foul. 13 teams play in the SEC. It'll be 14 momentarily. Vanderbilt is getting a program.
Are they really? That's awesome, isn't it?
It'll be a couple of years away.
And then you got two more coming in.
That's right.
That little, team from Norman, Oklahoma is coming into the league. And Texas.
Three, two. Outside ball four. What a plate appearance by Miklish.
And she did exactly what she's supposed to do. She set the table. She got on base. Now we'll see how Coach Rittman plays it. Will he ask Davenport to bunt? Will he play a little hit and run, or will he just let Miklish run? Some players you tell them to steal, some players you give the green light to, and you say if you get one, you feel it, good go.
Clemson does have one stolen base in this one. 17 this season.
Something that you don't often see is we have got a left-handed catcher back there. And with a right-handed hitter in the box, it may help. Well, see a single strike sneak through, and Miklisch has no trouble reaching third base.
And the Tigers with runners on the corners now, thanks to the single from Davenport. First hit for Clemson since the first inning.
Yeah, but they've got first and third, and they have got Clark up to bat. We're going to have a pinch runner for Reedy Davenport out at first base. It's going to be...
It'll be Baumhart. Like,
yeah, Baumhart. This is how everything started right here coming up for the Tigers today. This is Mackenzie Clark. And that ball was way out of here.
Yeah, hugs all the way around her fifth home run. Second most in the ACC, only minor teammate, Cagle. It's on top of the order. Mackenzie Clark steps in with runners on third and first. You just made an interesting point. Why do you think we don't see more left-handed catchers in softball and baseball?
Well, I don't really know the reason. It, you definitely see more of them in softball than you do baseball. But it's just like back in the early days is when the games were evolving, the vast majority of the hitters were right-handed. Mm-hmm. So it made sense to have a right-handed catcher where your throw was not obstructed by a batter.
Baumhart on the move, and the throw, did it hit her?
Yep, it did.
And then Baumhart will be out.
Yeah, that's a mental error right there by Baumhart.
Well, it looked like the initial throw to second might have got her around the ankle.
Watch this right here, what happens. Here comes the throw. See it tailing? And you're exactly right. She got hit in the foot by the ball. The ball stayed right there. But she didn't find the ball before she left the base. And that's one of life's little embarrassing moments.
Teaching moment for Baumhart.
Yes.
She was a member of the Clemson Club softball team a season ago.
We call that a learning moment.
So that's the first out of the inning.
Still got a runner out there on third base. You got Clark, followed by Moore, followed by Cagle.
Now Clark down in the hole at 1-2.
Now this right here is a big time at bat for Clark and for Walters. If you get Clark and don't allow the run to score, you got a chance to get out of this mess with first and third and nobody out.
One, two, swing and a miss.
And there it is. So now, watch this right here. You see Clark being aggressive, probably chased the ball off the plate. But you're not going to change the way she approaches hitting.
This inning started very promising for Clemson.
Yes, look how different the world we live in now. We had first and third, nobody out. Now we got a runner on third, two out, and a strike on the batter. That's how quickly things can change.
Good day so far for Maddie Moore.
Now, I will say this, in a lot of times in life, leadoff walks magically find a way to score. Mm-hmm. So Walters is trying to go against that adage. But more importantly, she's trying to get out of a mess and get her team back in there with a chance maybe to get back in this game.
She's approaching 70 pitches in relief. She did not anticipate having to come into the first inning in this one.
She may have thought she was going to work today, but I don't think she thought she was going to start work at 4:10.
That's it sharply. Foul, 2-2.
You know, that's what the big advantage of closers in Major League Baseball have, people like that. They know, you know, if the ball game starts at 7, you know, the earliest they're going to go to work is 9:30.
That's right.
So they kind of ease into the day. In this sport, when you've only got 4 or 5 maybe on the staff, you never know when you got to go to work.
Good cut there by Moore, 2-2.
You could not ask for a more pleasant day today. And I want you to know, Graham, that three nights ago at this ballpark, it was freezing.
I noticed the space heater when I walked in here.
And today, I mean, it's a shirt sleeve and shorts.
Up the middle, Walters snatches it, scoops it over to first, and she gets out of the jam. Clemson leaves a runner stranded on third. We played 4. It's a 5-run lead for the Tigers. Game summary so far, Clemson all the runs in the first inning. Georgia has yet to have a base runner.
Yeah, I don't want to talk a lot about it, but yeah, it's been pretty smooth sailing right now. If you're Miss Cagle, all the credit to her, because this is a tough batting order.
Yeah, we touched on it. Up top, Georgia leads the SEC in doubles, triples, and home runs. This is Kearney who takes ball one. Kearney out of New Jersey. Her father, Jay, played football at West Virginia and was drafted in the 6th round by the Green Bay Packers. Yeah.
A lot of athleticism in these teams.
That one knocked down by Moore. Throw to first, not in time, and Georgia has their first base runner.
And you got to score that a base hit, I think. May did a good job of knocking it down. It just kind of scooted away from her. That is not an easy play to make. She's going to say that she should have made the play. But I think you got to give the hitter the benefit of the doubt on that play.
Well, they have not made a ruling yet. There it is. It is ruled a base hit. There's a strike fired in Akuma. So Georgia's first hit, an infield single, and it comes here in the 5th. Ground ball to third, past the diving Davenport into left field. Hitting is contagious, 2 singles in a row.
And just as fast and just as sudden as we saw the Clemson Tigers jump out, the Georgia Bulldogs now have jumped out in this inning. And as we talked about an hour and 15 minutes ago, here's where the Tigers need to hit the reset button. They don't have to worry about anything other than getting an out right here. You'd give up the bases for out. You want an out.
Pass the catcher, Vieira can't get to it. Both runners advance a base. Kearney to third, Kuma to second.
This wouldn't be a bad time for the catcher to go out and talk with her pitcher. And remind her that she's still up 5 runs in this game. That had a tough luck single. Had a C&I single, nothing big has happened, just go back to work.
Pass Davenport, long throw to first, not in time. An infield single. Shamley just flying down the line, was able to beat the throw.
That's one time you may not want to take a look at the runner, you may want to just get the out. You see Logaleo takes time to look. And it gave the base runner a chance to just beat it out, and she did. And now the Dogs has got something going.
This is Jaden Goodwin. Chops the first pitch, foul. Does not have a base hit this season when the bases are loaded.
Yeah, the good news is for the Tigers is it is the 7-8-9 hitters in the lineup, but the bad news is it's Just a 7-8-9 hitters on a very, very good hitting Bulldog ball club.
Popped up, foul territory. May underneath and makes the catch. That is a crucial out for Clemson and Valerie Cagle.
That is significantly large. We'll bring up the shortstop Armstead.
Oh, for one with a line out. Down and inside for ball one. This is her first plate appearance this season with the bases loaded.
I'm surprised right now. You see the time's calling. Pitcher coach Kyle Jamerson is going to meander out to the mound. I am surprised that the Clemson offense playing halfway. I mean, defensive infield playing halfway. I believe I would play back. I'd give a run for an out. You're in the fifth inning.
And prior to this inning, Cagle has just been outstanding.
Look at that right there. That kind of shows you what they like to do. They pull the ball a lot, it appears.
Pretty balanced, though.
Yep, 39, 26, 35.
Georgia making moves on the bases.
Getting a little speed. Doing a little bit of an upgrade in legs out there at third base where maybe they can get a run across with a sack fly.
The new runner on third base, it's the sophomore, Dallas Goodnight, an Alabama transfer.
Yeah.
So Goodnight at third, Kuma on second, Shamley at first, one out in the inning. 1-0 count for Armstead, shows bunt. Misses.
And the huge thing is that has been in Cagle's pocket so far in the early part of this year is getting a strikeout when she needs one. And this would be a great time to get a strikeout, but 2-0 is not the part of town you want to be in. They do have an out to work with. Looks like they've backed the infield up a little bit.
Ground ball up the middle. Could this be two? There's one. Throw over by Moore. In time for the 6-4-3 double play. Georgia wants a review. We might have one. They will look at it. We'll keep it here. But for the time being, Clemson escapes a bases-loaded jam. This is a sure out right here.
I want to see it again. This could be a better angle. Let's see what we're thinking here.
And from that vantage point, Georgia might be feeling pretty good that they'll get a run on the board here.
If I had to guess, I would guess safe.
But again, it has to be overwhelming evidence to overturn the call.
Oh, I don't know. That may be a jump ball.
It's as close as you can get.
What a great job by our crew getting that. Terrific job with the cameras, guys and gals.
So again, the call on the field, 6-4-3 double play, no runs scored.
Now in the shadow of the glove, the shot we saw, this shot right here, see, we see the ball disappears, but we don't know if the ball is actually on the leather
right.
of the glove.
Yeah.
It may be, it's in the vicinity of it. But you got to remember now that the call is out. Oh boy, I don't know.
So it's hard to tell just because you can't see the right foot on this shot. So this is a big call coming up here. Georgia trying to scratch across their first run scored in the game. Here comes the call. And it is overturned. Wow.
Well, I originally said out of the gate, you know, if I had to guess, I would say safe. And I think that they deemed that it was just very, very conclusive that the foot was on the bag. And the old unwritten adage, which is, you know, it's just only an adage, the tie does go to the runner.
So again,
there you go. See, she comes in on the on that.
And Cagle will turn it, fire to first. The inning is over, but Georgia gets on the board. One run on three hits for the Bulldogs. It's a four-run lead for Clemson. Bottom of the fifth, Clemson leads Georgia 5-1. And Scott, you can put a star by that last sequence of events.
How different innings can make. In the first inning, when Clemson kind of got out on a fast start, they did. The Georgia defense and pitching didn't do necessarily a great job of damage control. That past half inning right there, Cagle, in spite of having bases loaded and nobody out, was able to hold the damage to one run, and they were half a step away from getting out of the inning altogether. So damage control is something that's just so important in this game. You want that from your pitchers, and right there, good job by Cagle, and there here she is leading off.
That's the way it works, isn't it?
Yep.
Make a play, you'll lead off. Valerie Cagle's been a part of all sort of history for Clemson softball. She hit the first home run ever in this ballpark.
Yeah,
and she had a walk-off solo home run against Virginia for the first ACC win.
It was gone.
That was a hot shot foul.
When she pulls one out of here, it goes all the way out to where the cars are. Of course, they've got a lot of construction going on right now here in the sports area here at Clemson, and there's a lot of cars out there in right center, in right field, and on around.
So it sounds like you're saying people can be nervous when Valerie Cagle's
yes.
in the batter's box?
Yes.
Swing and a miss, 1-2.
Took a little something off that pitch. That was an excellent change of speed there.
Oh, there are all the cars right there.
Yeah. I think baseball's at home today, too. So, I mean, that's two sets of fans right there.
Nice job by Cagle to stay alive. What have you seen in the circle from Walters today?
That she's as good as advertised. She's going out there. I mean, let's face it. I mean, her job was to hold them right there, and she's done that. I mean, she kind of got a run hung on her in the first inning. But that's one run. But if you look at the second, the third, and the fourth, Clemson's done nothing.
Here's a high chopper over Walters and in the center field.
Now that's going to be interesting how they rule this, because the second baseman was shaded by the pitcher. I don't think that she saw the ball. The second baseman, Kuma, who is a very good player. You watch, this ball stays down on her. Watch, the pitcher gets a chance, jumps, and if you see that, the ball took a funny bounce and stayed down on Kuma, and she never touched it. So I think it has to go as a hit. I don't know how they will score it, but I think it has been given a hit. And I think that's the right call. Because that ball, if you watch it, it had some overspin on it, and it stayed down. It did not bounce up. The second bounce did not match the first bounce. You got a pinch runner out there at first base running for Cagle. That looks like that's going to be Ainsley Houston. I believe I'm right.
It is, junior out of Grandfield, Georgia.
There she is.
Houston went to Noonan High School, same high school as one Alan Jackson, country music singer.
There you go.
If you're a fan of The Walking Dead, a lot of scenes were shot at her high school.
Okay.
Taking you're not a fan?
I don't know what it is. I know who Alan Jackson is.
Oh, 1 to Jacobson outside.
Well, Walking Dead, obviously, I know what, but I don't like scary stuff.
Yeah, I'm with you.
I frighten easily.
We share that.
Yeah, I get scared. I scream every morning when I shave.
That's why you have the goatee?
Yes.
That's low.
Less time. Yeah, it was low. You shouldn't take a shot like that. Thank you for acknowledging and apologizing.
Two-one the count on Jacobson.
A couple more outbursts like that, and I'm gonna have my bodyguard get you out of here, kid.
That is pulled foul. 2-2. Jacobson had the big RBI double in the first. All five of the runs for the Tigers in that first frame.
The Georgia Bulldogs are going to be just fine if they're going to have pitching performances like this out of Walters, because the rest of the staff will come around.
Mm-hmm.
And, the first inning was very significant today. No doubt about it. And they still may come back and make noise in this game. They've got two more sets of outs to work with.
Plus, their offense is always going to be there.
And I'm very, very impressed with what Walters is doing.
I just got a piece of the bat for Jacobson.
Right here. That was an I don't mean to. Saw a little bit of a grimace on her face. Not in pain, but in anger. Fighting it off. That's what you do. As you alluded to earlier.
This will be pitch number 11.
Is that right? Jacobson, as you said, Jacobson and Walters are not strangers to each other.
Yeah, Jacobson, 191 games at Duke. 3-2, runner on the move, ground ball up the middle. There's the out. Armistead slings it over to first. A 6-3 double play.
Taylor made. Great job right here by the shortstop, Armstead. She knows that she's got it on her own. Gets her foot over there and just gets it on over to first. Problem solved. And that changes the complexion of things.
She made that look easy.
Yeah, she's smooth.
Logan Leo steps in now with the bases empty. Look at Leo looking for the first hit of her career against Georgia.
Are we talking the university or the entire state?
The university. I guess that would be something if it was the entire state.
Surely she's had hits in the number of games she's played against Georgia Tech. They probably have played Georgia State.
Georgia Southern.
I don't know if they face Georgia Southern, but yes, that is another one.
Hits sharply to the shortstop. Kuma fires it over. And only three batters for Clemson in the bottom of the fifth. We played 5-4-run lead for the Tigers. Top of the sixth at Clemson. 5-1 our score. Clemson ahead of Georgia. Packed house this Tuesday evening. And this weekend, the Clemson baseball team will be in action against UCF out of the American Athletic Conference. First pitch will be Friday 4 Eastern. Should be a fun matchup. UCF, unique situation. Their starting quarterback on the football team, John Rhys Plumlee, is also a starting outfielder on the baseball team.
How about that?
You don't see that crossover a lot.
No, you don't. The Tiger softball team would be down in Florida, but if you're here in the area, the UCF Clemson baseball series is going to be a lot of fun.
Top of the order for Georgia to begin the sixth. This is Jaden Fields. That's hit sharply to make it 1-1.
She has a home run on the season, so she's got some pop. She
Got a bunch in her career, 18 total. This is a Georgia team. Last year, they had a program record 107 home runs hit. This is lifted to left field. Diving catch made by Miklisch. She didn't get a good read on it.
Oh, that ball's tailing. It had a tail on it. She broke one way, then had to correct herself, and then made an outstanding play. That was not easy. This ball is tailing toward the foul line. She got a slow jump on it. It was hit sharply, but she used good instincts and great quickness to haul that ball in. And look out there, look at Clark in center field, paying her the respect. That was awesome right there. Clark, one of the most prolific outfielders in the country, showing respect out there to Miklisch. Allie Miklisch out of Wisconsin. Came from out of the cold to make that play.
This is a Clemson team. They have had a lot of fun this season. When you win, you have fun. They're the only undefeated team in the ACC.
Well, I know that's a great number, and I know the fans love it, and everybody is excited about it, but Coach Rittman and the entire coaching staff will tell you, and the players will tell you, it's about improvement. It's about right now, this time of year, it's about the process.
There's a strike fired into Davis. Davis is from Calhoun, Georgia, won a 3A state title at Calhoun High School. Her dad, Michael, played baseball at West Georgia and is in their Sports Hall of Fame.
Calhoun is between Atlanta and Chattanooga, almost exactly halfway. Had a young lady played on my first team at Kennesaw State. Was from Calhoun, Georgia. Juliana Smallwood and her father, Ken Smallwood, was a big fan of ours.
Seems like Calhoun produces a lot of talent.
That's been a long time ago.
Well, you won a bunch of games.
Got a lot of hardware. A lot of years. And a lot of good players. And that's what any coach will tell you. If you want to become a good coach, get good players.
No matter the sport.
It does not matter. Coaching gets way too much credit when things are good and way too much blame when things are bad. It is about the players. And that's the way it should be. They are the stars of the show.
It's got to make you proud just to see how much the game of softball has grown over the years and how popular it is.
It is a lot to be proud of, but there were so many people who came before me that I'm so glad that they got to see it too while they were still coaching. Heroes that were there before I even got into it. Because this sport has been played for a while, and it was a good 20 years old when I got in. But it was still well off the radar. But there's a nice play by Logaleo.
Yes, it was, putting on a show for all these Clemson fans.
Goes up the middle. Yeah, that's not a hit. You thought it was, but it was not. You see her get it over there to May. Very well done. If you're going to have a good pitching outing, you're going to have help from your defense. And no matter how well, you see number 72 out there throwing the ball. Cagle has been helped by this defense. We saw it in left field just this half inning, and we just saw it at shortstop.
Ground ball over to Davenport, fires it across, and Georgia goes down in order. 1-2-3. Defense making plays. Miklisch diving catch for the out. Clemson rolling it home over Georgia. So this weekend, Clemson heading south to Tampa, playing in a tournament hosted by South Florida. Get a good mix a little everything Clemson will see this coming weekend, including taking on number 9 Tennessee.
Yeah, you're going to have meetings of two good friends and their ball clubs on Thursday night there down at South Florida with Kenny Erickson and USF and Coach Rittman and the Tigers. And then you've got...
Ooh, what a catch.
What a great play.
That's Curlin coming right at you.
Yeah. That right there is not easy to do. Yeah. She did a great job of keeping that ball, getting to the ball before it got into the netting. She did a good job of keeping herself safe from the netting and the wall.
First pitch, strike to JoJo Hyatt.
JoJo had that triple in the first inning.
Did you have a favorite spot that you wanted to go and play in a tournament?
Wherever the World Series was.
What an answer.
I mean, that's where I wanted to go every year. And I was blessed. I got to go 13 times during my career.
Where do you keep your rings?
Oh,
you ever wear them?
They're in my traveling museum, Scott Whitlock Experience.
That's outside, 1-2.
No, they're at a safe place. I don't get them out and wear them much, but...
Special occasions?
Yeah, I'm sure after the good Lord calls me home, my daughter and son will hock them quickly. I've just been very fortunate.
Two balls, two strikes on Hyatt. Story of this game for Georgia, it has been Shelby Walters in the circle. Clemson has not scored since the first inning. Here's a base hit to left field. JoJo Hyatt, an aggressive turnaround first.
He just keeps on hitting. I think you're going to see Coach Rittman run for her again. That's going to put Hyatt out of the game because she's already been run for once. You see, she just kind of inside out at that pitch. That wasn't really a great swing, but she just stayed on the ball with her eyes and her head and was able to flick that thing out into left field.
Change made at first base. It'll be the junior Oda out of Buford, Georgia.
Yeah. And Oda has been a big part of the upload of the Clemson program. She's done a little bit of everything for the Tigers during her time here.
She is fast, 13 stolen bases in her career. Do you think about that in a spot like this?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's a four-run game. If five runs, another run right now would be huge because that would mean that the Grand Slam can't tie you. I know that sounds crazy, but that's just the way a coach thinks.
There she goes, throw down a second, not in time. A stolen base for Oda. It's her first this season.
They took great advantage of the infield playing in because of the slapper, Miklisch. You look right here, they were playing in, so she got a great jump. Here's a little bit of trivia for you. JoJo Hyatt and Oda are high school teammates. Down in Buford, Georgia.
You can see why they won a bunch of games.
You better know it.
Bunch shown, it's a good one. First base side, throw to first, sends up in right field. Oda will score, there's the fifth run for Clemson.
How about that now? Is that manufactured a run? One out single, steal a base. Get a ball down, you get an error. That right there, that's what you call offensive pressure. They knew she ran well down the line. And Rittman's had her wound up.
Is that a fun feeling?
When you wave them home? Ain't nothing better than that. Unless they get thrown out, then you wish you hadn't wound them. Yeah. That's Well, you get paid to make those decisions.
So it is officially ruled a throwing error on the pitcher, Walters.
Oh,
that
yes.
run is unearned.
Did they give her a sacrifice on that? Or was
they,
it a
they did not.
Fielder's choice? Yeah, a sack and an error. Yeah, you see the brain trust of the Clemson softball team. He's calling timeout. He must know he's on TV right now. Look at him. He's walking down there slow. He knows the camera's on. Look at him grinning. Yeah, I'm on TV right now. You know that, don't you? And I guarantee you right now, this time of day, they're probably Rittman's probably talking about maybe what does he want for dinner. But that's important to John. He's easing his way back out there now. Got a five-run lead telling Reedy to get a good hit. One out, so he's showing everybody he knows what's going on.
Line drive, base hit to left center field. Miklas, she'll get waved home. Armstead, though, off the mark, and another run scores for Clemson. 7-1 lead for the Tigers.
And that was great aggression by John Rittman, and maybe a little bit of the Georgia defense taken for granted that the base runner was going to slide and stop at third base. As you see, Davenport goes there and hits a line drive single, but it's in the gap. Miklas is motoring to third base, which everybody thought, but the throw came in towards second base, the cutoff at second base. And once Coach Rittman saw that, they were just all wound up. And that's going to bring Clark up. She's going to get one more chance to hit.
Well, you said at the start of this inning, Clemson should feel good about at least one run. They get two here in the sixth.
That's just the way it goes, you know. And now, if Clark were to accidentally run into one and get it out of the park, the game's over. You got a six-run lead right now with a runner out there on second base and a red-hot hitter at the plate.
That's definitely on the table. Clark, the leadoff batter, second most home runs in the ACC. Shows bunt.
I think that was on her own. I don't think that was anything called by the head coach. She just saw the defensive lineman and thought she'd try to sneak one by. If I'm coaching third, I'm wanting to grip it and rip it. I got one of the best pitchers in the country in the dugout. I got a good defense. I got a six-run lead. See if you can get me out of here.
That was a big swing
and
right there.
Exactly what she was trying to do then. You see right there, the pond was in play right there. She was going for it.
One, two from Walters, hit in the air, right field, curling out of play.
Tell you what, every time we come up here to work, Graham, we get such great work out of our production crew, the camera people, the support staff, everybody. This is just such an enjoyable experience, and want to thank everybody involved. Of course, much of our broadcast is under the guidance of Rick Bagby. Heads up all of the video stuff around here at Clemson. Does an excellent job. Does a particularly great job in hiring color analysts. I find that to be a strong suit.
It's not easy being humble, is it?
Well, I'm a very humble person. You should hear me when I'm bragging.
That's called strike three. Walters with her fourth strikeout. Look at the reaction from Clark.
Well, dump. And that might have been out of the zone, but you're up six runs, so don't yell too much about it. That brings up Loomis, California's Matty Moore. Had a double back in the first inning.
There's a nice swing. If you're thinking about home runs for Matty Moore, she has cracked five in her career.
And if I'm reading the statistics correct, Walters is now over 100 pitches. So Ohio State's pitcher Smith Saturday night throw 149 pitches in a cold night.
That's impressive for this early this season.
When the game was over with, my arm hurt. Just had like a relapse just from memory of that. But she worked really, really hard that night. And Ohio State gave Clemson all they wanted on Saturday night. Now, Clemson overwhelmed them on Sunday. But they did a good job on Saturday night battling the Tigers.
Well, this will be pitch number 10 this inning.
And right here is when Matty Moore could really just pick out a spot and try to drive one. I mean, you're playing with house money right now.
Misses inside for ball four.
Well, 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 look who's coming to the pitch.
Speaking of home runs.
So one more time, they're going to get to see her. And I think everybody here at Clemson knows what a treat and just how special a time it is to be a fan here with having a player like this in the program. These don't come around every year.
No, not at all. But not only at the plate, but in the circle.
I'm just talking about, this is an elite player.
Yeah.
And John Rittman tells me that if called upon athletically, she could play shortstop. She plays first base on the nights that she don't pitch. She's an extremely good fielder.
Huge swing and a miss.
Yes. Very quiet, unassuming. But it has grown as a competitor and as a player her time here. She had the skills when she showed up.
This will be out of play. One ball, two strikes on Valerie Cagle. Leads the ACC in home runs this season. She has 46 in her career.
Yeah. That's a lot for when you're, only about 120 games maybe into your career, maybe 100 or so. You had the COVID year and then the two full years of competition.
Swing and a miss. Walters picks up her fifth strikeout. Clemson tacks on two more runs. They do it on two hits. Georgia down to their final three outs when we come back. We have reached the top of the seventh. It's a 7-1 advantage for Clemson taking on Georgia for just the third time in program history. First true road game this season for Georgia.
Yep, and they made the hour and a half drive up and kind of got just swarmed in the first inning. And it's been a very, very, if you take that half inning away, it's been a very close ball game. But they all count.
Valerie Cagle this season, she has gone the distance five times.
Yep, and she's come in for a save.
One hopper up the middle, diving stop by Moore, throw to first. What a play by Matty Moore.
She's going to be called safe at first base. May did not hold the bag.
Home plate umpire came out to make the signal. Here's the replay.
I think this is a good job of officiating by first base umpire Tim Cassati. He asked for help immediately. And I think she did not hold the bag, I don't think.
Yeah.
They're going to look, but I don't think this is going to take very long.
Third review that we have had in this one.
The first one that Clemson's called for, though, correct?
Correct. Here's a different angle.
Yep. There's a ball right there. You see the ball? Ball's there. That's a good shot of the ball. Their foot is clearly off the base there, but a couple of frames before that was her foot on the bag. I don't think so. I think they're going to call her safe. That's what I'm guessing. I was right on my first guess today, so I'm due to be wrong, but I'm guessing safe.
And remember, it was called safe.
Yes.
On the field of play. So if it stands, this would be just the fourth base hit for Georgia today. That would be the most challenging angle to tell right there.
If she's on the base, she's out. If she's holding the base right there, she's out, but that's hard to tell.
So here they come. Here's the call. Call stands, fourth base hit for Georgia today.
I truly think they got that right.
So that means you're two for two.
Yep, I'm not going to guess any more tonight. I know when to get up and walk away from the table.
Sydney Kuma steps in.
She's one for two on the day.
That base hit extends her hitting streak. She's got a team-high nine-game hitting streak now. Now she's down in the count 0-2.
He's only a 419 hitter, though. We talked about her pregame. This is a very good offensive player.
I haven't seen a lot of rise balls today.
Nope, been a lot of curve balls, a lot of drop balls, working in and out. That's why the Crafts call pitching and not throwing.
Turned on foul, 1-2 it stays.
Coach Baldwin did a great job there of pretending like he might want to try to make a play on that, but he had no intentions of letting that ball near him.
Hitting the air to right field. On the move, Jacobson makes the catch. She'll turn and fire it back in.
The speed of the Clemson outfield makes impossible plays look tough and tough plays look easy. There's a ball right there that was tailing away from the right fielder. And if you watch Jacobson, she just keeps running through it and makes the catch. Had the presence of mind to wheel and get that ball in toward the proper location to hold the runners, and there's one out in the seventh.
Chamblee, could this be two? Diving stop by Moore from her knees. Throws it over to first to record the out.
Now that was a nice play too, right there. Everybody had a presence of mind to do exactly what you should do, and that's get the out. We don't care about the runner going to second base. We want an out. Moore does a great job. The out's made, and now they're down to one out. Right now, as an outfielder, you're being told, keep the ball in front of you. We don't care if the run scores. Keep the hitter off second base, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So everything is looking really good for the Tigers right now.
Clemson trying to remain the only undefeated team in the ACC.
And more importantly, this is a quality win.
Yes.
I mean, when down the road, when they're looking at stuff in terms of seeding and bids and whatnot.
OK, Could this be the final out? Logaleo over to first, and Clemson knocks off Georgia at home 7-1. Nice win for the Clemson Tigers, knocking off SEC foe Georgia.
Outstanding game all the way around by the Tigers. They jumped on them early, they scored often, and then they got a great pitching performance and great defense to back it up.
Best start in program history for Clemson. Valerie Cagle goes the distance for the sixth time this season in the circle. Clemson scored 5 runs in the first, tacked on a couple more late. Final thoughts, Scott?
Outstanding performance today by the Tigers. It finishes up this would be 5-game homestand in good stead, and they get ready to go on the road. And the road will be another test for them, and just part of the process, as coaches say.
So Clemson wins it 7-1 over Georgia. For my partners, Scott Whitlock, for a fantastic crew here at Clemson. Graham Doty signing off. Final score, Clemson 7, Georgia 1.